In this video, I'm going to show you the best way to remove wrinkles, blemishes, and other distractions in Photoshop. Hi, welcome back to the Photoshop Training Channel. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you several different techniques that you must know to remove wrinkles, blemishes, and other distractions in Photoshop. We're going to use the Spot Healing Brush Tool, and I'm going to teach you how you can use the different modes so that you get the results that you want. You probably have not even noticed them before. I'm also going to show you a very useful technique that you can use so that the hard-to-see blemishes in the skin become more noticeable so that you can remove them. Just like every other PTC tutorial, this video will be filled with tips and tricks. Okay, let's get started. We're going to work with this document. It contains this portrait, and we're going to use the Spot Healing Brush Tool to remove wrinkles and other distractions from his face. I'm going to zoom in to the side of his face, and as you can see, he has wrinkles on the side of his eye. We can use the Spot Healing Brush Tool to minimize the wrinkles on the side of his face. And by the way, in this tutorial, I'm going to push things to the extreme, but when you're retouching, try to keep adjustments to a minimum. Subtle effects work best, in my opinion. It's not good to completely remove wrinkles or other characteristics of the face. It's always best to just minimize them instead of removing them, but that's just my opinion. But anyway, we have the Spot Healing Brush Tool selected. Also, make sure that in the options bar, you select sample all layers so that we can create a new layer, a blank layer, and generate new pixels when we paint with the Spot Healing Brush Tool. See that, how we generated new pixels? And the reason that we're doing that is so that we can work non-destructively and always come back to the original photo if we need to. But anyway, I'm going to create a new blank layer. And when you have the Spot Healing Brush Tool selected, you can use the bracket keys in the keyboard to increase or decrease the size of your brush. I'm tapping on the left bracket key now to reduce the size of my brush. Then I can paint away the distracting element. Now, I'm going to increase the size of the brush and show you why this is not the way I prefer working. So I'm going to paint, and you'll notice that it does remove the wrinkles, but Photoshop also adds extra detail onto those areas. That is because I'm using Content Aware, and Content Aware looks at surrounding pixels from the areas that I painted on, and it uses those pixels to generate the new pixels. So it generated skin texture on those areas where it really doesn't work. So I know that some of you may be thinking, well, you use one giant brush stroke and that's why it generated those pixels. A good way to work is to reduce the size of your brush and do small brush strokes. And that's right, that would certainly work and do a much better job. But in some cases, you're still going to run into that same problem when you generate pixels that don't necessarily work, or you'll get a very smooth skin texture like we have here, and it really doesn't work. So in my opinion, the best thing to do is to create a new layer, select the Spot Healing Brush Tool, make sure that you have Content Aware selected, and sample all layers. Then think of your blemish. Is it darker or brighter than the skin tone? In this case, my distracting element, the wrinkle, is darker than the skin tone. So I want to lighten that. So I'll go down into the mode dropdown and select lighten. If the blemish was lighter than the skin tone, then I would darken it. In this case, I'm just going to select lighten. So with lighten selected, I'm just going to paint away those wrinkles. And notice one thing, that I can't really paint away the bright areas. So for example, if I come under the eye here and paint, I'm removing the darker pixels, but I don't really remove the bright pixels, which give definition to the skin texture. So I think it'll be more clear if I hold the space bar, click and drag to pan, and paint away this wrinkle here. Notice how I still have the highlight of the wrinkle, but not the dark areas of the wrinkle. And that's because I'm targeting the darker pixels, and just like everything else, when you have more control, you get better results. So I can now double click on the hand tool to fit the image to screen, and I can see the before and the after. As I said before, I like subtle effects. So usually what I like to do is just bring down the opacity to zero. So that brings the wrinkles all the way back to their original state and increase the opacity until you find a happy medium. So something like that. That's before and after. And to show you why I like this technique much better, I'm going to go into this document here. We have this older gentleman, and if I zoom in to his forehead, you can see that he has these fine white hairs on his forehead. And there's also blemishes. So if I create a new layer, select the Spot Healing Brush tool, make sure that Sample All Layers is checked and Content Aware is selected, I can look at my blemish. Is it brighter or darker than the skin tone? In this case, it's darker, so I want to lighten it. So when I start painting away those blemishes, watch what happens to the fine hairs on his forehead. I'm not really affecting those fine hairs because I'm targeting the darker pixels on his forehead. So it might not be that noticeable now, but when I double click on the hand tool and disable this layer, you can see how I was able to remove those blemishes without affecting the important detail on his forehead. I can even remove this blemish there and not really affect the detail of the hair. And that's because I'm only targeting the darker pixels. You can also see that here when I remove this blemish, that I remove the actual blemish, but the dead skin around it stays there because those pixels are brighter. And that's what these adjustments do. They target dark pixels or bright pixels. You just have to decide if you want to target the dark pixels or bright pixels depending on your portrait. What I'm going to do now is show you a technique that brings out the difficult to see blemishes in a face. So we're going to work again with this portrait, and it has already been retouched, so the portrait is actually pretty good. But even then, there are some difficult to see blemishes that I'm going to show you how to bring out. So I'm going to create a black and white adjustment layer. Then I'm going to reduce the reds and increase the yellows so that we can better see the skin tone. And you may have to fine tune this a little bit in your photos until you can actually see the skin. And the reason I adjusted the reds and yellows is because that's where the skin tones are found in all skin tones, no matter the ethnicity. So I'm going to zoom in into this area here, and you can actually see some of these blemishes that are coming out in the skin. You can see that they're barely noticeable or not noticeable at all without the adjustment layer. But if I enable this adjustment layer, you can see it there. So I can fix it by clicking on the portrait layer, creating a new layer, selecting the Spot Healing Brush tool, and just like before, look at the blemish or distraction. It's darker than the skin tone, so that means we want to lighten it. So select Lighten. Then I can reduce the size of my brush by tapping on the left bracket key on the keyboard, and I can start painting away those blemishes, like so. And there's some here in the nose, and I'm not going to do all of them, but I'll do just enough so that there's a difference when I do the before and after. And I think that should be enough. So I'm going to disable the black and white adjustment layer. So that's before and after. So notice that originally these blemishes were really, really hard to see, and we were able to remove them fairly easily by having a black and white adjustment layer and reducing the reds and increasing the yellow so that you can really see the skin tone. And again, in your image, you may have to fine tune these a little bit differently so that you can actually see the skin, but the blemishes should stick out at some point. Before and after. And let me know in the comments if you knew this black and white adjustment layer technique to bring out difficult to see blemishes. And by the way, when you're working with Photoshop and you're working with any tool, I recommend looking at the options bar in the flyout menu, because usually that's where Adobe hides the good stuff. For example, you might remember a tutorial I just did a few weeks ago where I showed you how to auto white balance a photo by using a hidden algorithm. That is another very useful technique that is hidden, just like the modes in the Spot Healing Brush tool. And I'll post a link to that video down below in case you're interested. Also, talking about videos that I recently have made, I just did a tutorial on how to whiten eyes that I think is really good and that I recommend. I'll also post a link to that video right below in the description. And I have one question for you. Please let me know in the comments which one was the first PTC video that you ever watched. You can put the title if you remember it or describe it. I'm really curious to know what video led you to start following the Photoshop Training Channel. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, please click on that subscribe and notification buttons. That way you're notified whenever I post any tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again very soon.